Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I'm going to show you, or today I'm going to just continue the demonstration that I started previously. I'm going to show you how you can extract credentials from this particular router. Now the same procedure applies elsewhere, but you need to grab that model number either by doing extensive nmap scanning or by just going using a far simpler method trying to authenticate. Well, actually we don't need to type any credentials. You can just go to the website, go to the login website and see if any information is revealed there. Apparently for most of the home routers you're gonna get a model number there as an authentic, or at the very least you will get the manufacturer name. Anyway, I've attempted to download ROM0 file from my browser, but now I am going to use the Wget, and Wget is a piece of code, is a piece of software that should be installed by default, but just in case it is not, type in yum search Wget, press enter, and there you go, the last one is Wget. Just type in yum install space Wget and it will be installed. Clear the screen. So Wget http://192.168.1.1. Keep in mind I'm using the local address here, but you can use a public IP address, so this router for all intents and purposes could be in Japan on the other side of the globe. For myself, it would not matter, this attack would still go and fly. /rom-0, that's O-0, press enter, and there, oh, it has saved it under ROM2. So I've already downloaded it twice. I guess this is the second time around that I'm attempting to make this tutorial. For some strange reason, either the connection crashes or I have some problems. But in any case, let's just go ahead and proceed with this. So let me just clear the screen. And now we need something to read that ROM. Let me just show you how that looks like. I'm going to use the original one that I've downloaded it. I don't know why, it just feels right because I'm downloading it already for the second time. Anyway, this is how the binary file looks like. You can't really read through this. You might get here and there pieces of readable code, but there you go, at the bottom. At the bottom you have a little bit that's readable, but none of this information is actually of any particular use to you. Just go ahead and press quit to quit it. And we need something to actually interpret this. In order for us to interpret this, I have a bunch of websites here that I have opened for this purpose. And you see here you have ZT, TP-Link, Zin, OS, Huawei, ROM0 configuration, decompressor. So this will make the file readable. In short, you can just go ahead and copy this script into a file, and now I want you to do this on your own. If you fail to do it, feel free to post it in the question section. I will be more than happy to explain it to you how. Here's a bit of a hint. You need to just copy this text into a text file. That text file must have an extension of .py, and you must make it executable. So chmod space plus x and the name of the file then follows. This is the format of the file. So ls. This is how your file should look like. It should have a .py and it should have a plus x. So type in chmod plus x, plus x, and then name of the file. Just clear the screen, zte rom reader .py, rom0, press enter, and there we go. It actually just reads right through it, and it converts it to a human readable form, you can put it so. But it doesn't actually bother to go through the whole file, to give us the contents of the whole file. It's mainly concerned is with the password for the router. So you have it here. Usually these things are the password, and there you go here, and then you have the password alone. So router password is 26 32 97. You can use this password to password that is obtained in such a manner to log into the router. Now, there comes a problem with this method. If anybody has messed around with the router, well, actually, on some of these routers, I've noticed that you can't actually change the username, which is very interesting. And then the default username is admin. So you can just use admin as a login name. Maybe sometimes I've seen that they use a login name root. But you can also go on the net and type in default login names for that particular brand of the router, and you can try a couple of them. Usually there's like maximum of 4 or 5, something like that. You're not gonna get 100 different variants. Just try a few of them, see how it works. But this is the password for sure. You will be able to log into it, to the router with it. All that remains is finding the username, but 99% of the time the username will be admin, so no worries there. Although some of the routers, they give very unique usernames, but they are public, so just go on the net, type in the router model, and apply that particular username. Now, before you actually try to do something crazy like this, try the default login credentials. Type in admin, and if admin doesn't work, take the model number, type it into your favorite search engine, and type in default credentials, because default credentials can vary from a router to router, and if the router is in a different country, see the IP address of the router, see to who it belongs. Let me just show you how you can do that. Major IP blocks. I believe I've showed you this website before. Come on, there we go. So it says here, it gives the IP addresses, it gives the IP address ranges, and then the owner should be written in the far right, but apparently I don't have it. Come on, look at how many IP addresses are for US alone. That's like a lot. And it doesn't list the owners for the US, strangely, but it doesn't matter. Look, I can just take this address, copy it. Come on, man. Why are you doing this to me? Why? I do not care for the Google Store. I gotta delete this somehow so I don't click on it. Who is? And so it doesn't, you'll get the owner of the IP address here. Once you get the owner of the IP address here, if it's a telecom, and if it's a router, then it's definitely a telecom. If it's a home router, then what I want to say, then it's definitely a telecom. Once you actually figure out which telecom it is, you can go ahead and type on the net configuration manuals of that particular telecom for that particular router, because usually telecoms keep such files public, and you can read the default username and default password there, which are unique to that particular telecom, because they can vary from one place to another. This is primarily to prevent people from just mass scanning the internet. Well, one of the reasons anyway, to prevent people from mass scanning the internet and then just trying the credentials admin. They still have default credentials, they're just not admin, so a lot of the scripts will actually fail to authenticate against them. But if you just bother to look a bit further, you will realize that the credentials are still public. They can be changed by the users, of course, but users rarely do this, and I mean rarely. Anyway, I'm going to call the tutorial here. In the next one, we're going to do pre-authentication exploitation. And until then, I bid you farewell.